about last night. Though things didn't look just right, please believe me, there was nothing wrong.
It's all right, do not worry. I know we have done Girl Happy recently, but there's a very good reason for this follow-up video. You may remember when I showed you this original Al Devoren copy of Girl Happy from 1965. I couldn't play it. Well, I'd never played the original for you, as I am right now. No,
sorry. Very hard to handle like a Model T. Across my heart, I hope to die. Girl, I wouldn't tell you no lies.
No, I wouldn't tell you no lies. What is this witchcraft I hear you cry? How can you be playing Al Devoren's warped copy of Girl Happy from 1965? Well, let me tell you a little story, because I know we all love stories. I was perusing eBay earlier last week. Don't tell her downstairs. Perusing through eBay, and I saw this advertisement for I Can Flatten Your Warped Records. Can you? Yes. This guy called Mirror John, he's on eBay, and he ran this beautiful advertisement about he can flatten any type of warped record, provided it's not shellac. So that rules out your 78s. And I've sounded good. So anyway, I contacted John and I thought, well, let's see what you can do with my copy of Girl Happy. Very reasonably priced. I think it was £8.90 to flatten the record and to return it to me. So I thought, right. I contacted him. He sent me an email back saying, no problem, Scott. Just send me the record over. I'll have it for a few days. I'll flatten it. Hopefully I can flatten it and I'll send it back to you. I'll give it a full clean, this, that and the other. Not worried about the clean, because as you guys know, I clean all my own vinyl anyway. And hence, since it's come back to me again today, I've re-cleaned it because I'm very fussy about what I put on my turntable. I received this letter with it. Let me read it for you. Oh, but before we do that, this was the original airmail envelope that this record was sent to Al Devoren. Now, by all today's standards, it's not the strongest envelope that you would send out your precious cargo. But I guess in those days, this Girl Happy, oh, I don't know how many Colonel Tom Parker sent out. The reason I know it's from Colonel Tom Parker is because on here, the postage stamp says MGM 40th anniversary. Now, this was sent on the 22nd of March, 1965 from Culver City, California. Now, what have I mentioned to you plenty of times before? In Culver City, whereas Elvis did most of his interior shots. And Girl Happy is no different. So this was sent out from the Culver City lot, which is quite remarkable, really. 99 cents to post that, which is good by today's standards, isn't it? And it was sent to Mr. Al Devoren, 54W Randolph Street, Chicago, Illinois, is that? I gather so. And it says Colonel Tom Parker, 1838. Now, did Colonel Tom Parker live at 1838 Madison or not? I'm not sure. I might have got that wrong. But even if he was staying in California, that might have been the address that he was staying at. But that is really quite a bit of history there in my hand. So anyway, back to the letter from John. Hi, Scott. Spelt with one T. Quite a few people do that. And it is, in fact, two. Hi, Scott. Please find enclosed your record returned to you. I think you will agree it is 100% flatter now than previously. We will continue. There was only a small amount evident of wow, awe and flutter that is always apparent per revolution with this form of warping. That has now disappeared. and the clarity on playback has improved also with the cleanup of your vinyl. There is, however, a slight lift, nothing much, 0.5 millimetres per revolution. This, however, is not detrimental to quality of playback and well within the manufacturer's tolerance. Your album is returned to you in a poly-lined sleeve to avoid contamination. It has been a pleasure working on your vinyl, Scott, and I hope you consider my service should you need it in the future. Many thanks and kindest regards, John. Yes, John. Well, it needed it, didn't it? I'm in a celebratory mood after receiving that rather fabulous letter from John, receiving back my flattened record. Now, when I looked at John's advert further, he can do 45s, he can do records up to 180 grams, but nothing more than that. But he cannot always guarantee success. Now, he will try once to flatten it, twice to flatten it, three times a lady to flatten it, and if he can't get it on the third time, he'll have to give up on it. But I think what the process is, he uses this Org machine, he puts your record inside, he heats it up for 2 hours, and then he allows it to cool. But of course, all the time it's heating, I imagine it's compressed. I don't know, but that is what I would recommend, or what I would think he does on it. And I have looked at the machines, and I'll put a picture up of it, so you can have a look. But yes, the record returned to me this morning, and I've now got a perfect playing copy of Girl Happy, and some with some provenance and some history, which of course makes it altogether better and makes the story better, because it's much better to have a bit of history with the records, I find. This used to play very badly.
Every time you look at me, I'm as helpless as can be. I become a puppet on the string.
Anyway, I just thought I would share my marvellous news with you this morning. And should any of you guys want this guy's name, obviously if you're in the UK, probably a bit expensive if you want to post them from the USA, but I'm sure there are people that do it across the pond. I'll put a link to John's account on eBay in the description. Look, I only know John from talking for him on eBay, and we corresponded just on two messages, so I haven't told him I'm doing this today. He doesn't know me from Adam, well, he doesn't know me of course apart from Scott, but the service that he provided I thought was absolutely wonderful, and to preserve a record such as this for the sake of £8 something, I thought was money well spent. It saves me buying another copy, and I really didn't want to. I wanted the original record with this magnificent sleeve that in fact stays framed on my wall. But I've got one of those quick release frames that I can just pull it out when I need to. And I've also got quite a few more sealed original 1960s albums that have turned up just of late. And I will do a video on them in the coming weeks and months ahead. But that was all I wanted to do today, just to share with you my fascinating find. So if you've had that warped record that you feel that you're going to give up on it, or you've pinned it to the wall, or you've thrown it as a frisbee or anything, don't do it. Give this gentleman an opportunity to flatten it for you. Look, you can tell I'm pretty stoked today, because I really didn't expect to have that kind of result. Thank you very much for watching. Like I say, just a quick video just to show you that, you know, anything's possible. If you only believe. Take it away, E. Take him out.
You can do most anything.
I'll be back this week. Maybe Thursday if you're lucky. Maybe Friday. But I will be back, I promise.